Hello, welcome to Celluloid Mirror. I'm your hostess, Betty St. Laveau. On this show, we discuss films, movie stars, and film trivia. Today, we're going to focus on the unknown. And what I mean by the unknown are movies I've never watched. Whenever someone has said, "Have you ever seen that movie?" and I've said no, they're like, "I can't believe you're a film person and you never checked that out." But it just goes like that sometimes. And we all have movies that we have missed over the years. So here's my list. It's sort of on the infamous side, but who knows? I wish I could talk to the audience right now so that you too could tell me what are your movies that you've never seen. Let's check this list out. Dirty Dancing. No, I don't know that anyone doesn't back Baby into a corner. I've never seen this movie and I love Patrick Swayze. So I'm gonna I'll catch it sometime. Next is Fast Times at Ridgemont High. Phoebe Cates, I find that she's adorable. And I know that she's married to Kevin Kline and that her father, Gil Cates, has produced an Oscar show and he's a famous producer. But have I ever seen this movie past the credits? No, I have not. Gotta check it out sometime. Next is Flashdance. She's a maniac, but I really wouldn't know it because I've heard the song 1,000 times, but I never caught Jennifer Beals doing her thing. Next, Gone with the Wind. No way am I ever gonna watch this racist turkey. Forget about it, okay? Avatar. I think James Cameron is a bit of a genius. I like his movies with Arnold. But I just haven't seen the blue people fly around yet or whatever, but maybe one day I will. Midnight Cowboy. This movie has a very serious subject, and I think that that's one of the reasons why I've never watched it. It's about life in the big city, very gritty. Not surprised that I've missed it. The Graduate. I've said it before, and I've said it again. No, whenever this came on TV, Ma would never let us watch it. We always had to go to bed. I'm just saying. True Grit. I believe that the Duke, Mr. John Wayne, got an Oscar for this. I know that there's a remake. I have siblings who have either seen the old one, or nephews and nieces. I've had family members who have either seen the old one or they've watched the new one, and opinions are divided. I have yet to catch it. Cool Hand Luke. I love Paul Newman, but I've never seen him and the Mr. There go a mano. Maybe one day I will. I guess I just don't want to see Paul Newman get beat up. Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid. Nope, have missed it. I think it came out when I was 8 or 9, just missed it. The Sting, another one that I've never seen. I need to watch that one. And the last one, Bullet. Again, I think it was Betty By time so that Ma could have a date with Steve McQueen. So there's my list of movies I've never seen. Maybe in a few years, I will have watched a few of them. I know everybody has that list. And when you check out your list, I'm sure it's very fascinating. All right, so next we are going to give a shout out to Dendry Allen Taylor. Simply because I began Sons of Anarchy, repeat it for myself, the first season. I love her acting. She plays Kay Segal's character, Gemma Teller's best friend, Gemma Tellamora, best friend, and love her acting. I've mentioned her on the show before. She was in the first scene of Into the Furnace, and I just caught her in Hollywoodland, which, again, I'm just rewatching it, and I really like her acting. She's very talented. She's the Wikipedia entry, and thank you, Wikipedia. I don't give you enough credit. I use Wikipedia for facts. I could only find a German entry for her, so the translation is a little bit tricky, but she was actually in Ivan Reitman's Twins years and years ago, Danny DeVito and Arnold Schwarzenegger, and on some Star Trek shows, which is pretty cool. And was in War of the Worlds. And basically, I think Bold and the Beautiful, but the German translation says Rich and Beautiful. At any rate, please check her out. She's crazy beautiful, all right? Now, so her television filmography is Beauty and the Beast, and that was the show with Ron Perlman and Linda Hamilton. I never saw that either. A couple Diagnosis Murder, a Silk Stockings episode. I love Silk Stockings. That's Mitzi Capture and my man Rob. What's Rob's last name? I love him. Criminal Minds, great actress. Next, I think that today, the main movie that I would like to talk about is Donnie Brasco. I can't remember the first time I watched it, and I'm unsure if or when I've reviewed it on the show or commented on it. I know I have. Rewatching it this past 3 or 4 days, what a gem. It is definitely one of my top 25 movies in the whole world. I love the script. I love the direction. I love the exposition. I like the storyline, the relationship between Donnie Brasco and Lefty. And it's not so much a buddy movie, I realize, but a father and son movie or a teacher mentor movie. So, it's based on a true story. Joe Pistone went undercover and infiltrated the mob. Hundreds of arrests were made, indictments were flown around the room, and he had to go into witness protection. When I watched this movie, and especially towards when I'm watching Lefty's story arc, it has always wrenched my heart until I read that in real life, the real Lefty did not get rubbed out or hurt by the mob. So this makes me feel great. Well, it makes me feel better watching the movie. However, Al Pacino's nuanced, I'm quoting another writer, his nuanced performance is extremely moving. He is always hoping that someone will give him the respect that he deserves. All I want to do is hug Lefty the entire time through the movie. I really love Pacino's performance. What can I say? The man's a genius. And so is Johnny Depp. I own more movies of him than any other movie star. And I've always taken his acting lightly. I now realize he's a genius. When I watched Ed Wood several times this past spring, Johnny has it. He's very good at his craft. He must be really enjoyable to work with. I think. So I just wanted to say a shout out and bless you and yours, Johnny, no matter what. He definitely has it. So watching him with Martin Landau in Ed Wood, it was again the mentor or the mentor protege or father son relationship. And here, and when he's relating with Mr. Pacino, it was he's playing a bad dude. He's playing a FBI guy who is going to take this guy down, and he doesn't really care about him. But after a while, because of the relationship the characters have together, the regret of what Donnie is doing, or Joe Pistone is doing, shows on Mr. Depp's face, right on Johnny Depp, okay? So it had a $35 million budget, and it earned $124 million, which is awesome. The film was nominated for an Oscar for Best Adapted Screenplay. It was based on Donnie Brasco, My Undercover Life of the Mafia by Joseph D. Pistone and Richard Woodley. It was produced by Mark Johnson, Barry Levinson, Louis D. Giacomo, Gail Mitreau, and it starred Al Pacino, Johnny Depp, Michael Madsen, Bruno Kirby, James Rousseau, Anne Hesch, and also Gretchen Mol playing Michael Madsen's girlfriend there. Music by Patrick Doyle, distributed by Sony Pictures. The release date was February 24th, 1997. It's got a running time of 127 minutes, and it was in development hell for years, I think 6 years. Goodfellas was being produced at the same time, or had just come out, and so there was some tension about the release date. Because of that, you all need to check out that info. But it's in this article. This, the critical response, of course, is very positive. There are many funny moments in this movie. It's only a great crime thriller. There's a lot of humor in it. Michael Madsen doing his shoulder dance at the club makes me, I just laugh. I love how he dances. And the whole exchange between Donnie and Lefty about friend of yours, friend of mine, well, am I a friend of yours? I love that, okay. There's other funny parts. I think I wrote them down. Friend of yours, friend of mine. Oh, and the strip club scene where Lefty gets his porch. I love that. So at any rate, I just want to say that sometimes when we're looking at movies, and you know, we don't know the actors, we don't know the lives of the production crew, everyone who is giving their blood, sweat, and tears to make these movies. But when the movie is translated to where we're watching it and we're seeing it, when we see great performances, we have to say right on, all right? So thank you everyone who had a hand in making Donnie Brasco. Okay, so I almost think that that's it for me. I'm your hostess, Betty St. Laveau. I hope you've enjoyed this episode of Celluloid Mirror. Please keep away from those bad movies. And I'd like to thank, in closing, the production crew here at Orca for helping me talk about movies, and my ma, Sharon Ardella Warfield Paris Ochisana Klarich, who taught me how to love movies. Okay, see you all later. Ciao.